So considering this example, A is not equal to B, not equal to C, and they belong to real number. All of them are distinct real number. Linear equation x minus a x minus b will turn out in a quadratic equation. This is a quadratic and this is also a quadratic equation. Sum of quadratic equation is a quadratic equation. So overall this is a quadratic equation. Right? Na? Agree or not? This is a quadratic equation. Because these are constants and constants has hardly contribution in terms of degree. Constant has no contribution. Who will determine the degree? Variable. So variable is x into x, that will be x square. So this is a quadratic equation, this is quadratic, this is quadratic. Okay? Agree? So a quadratic equation can have maximum two roots, no more. This is what we have learned. Now, let me explain this. If I put x is equal to a here, then what will happen? A minus a, 0. The whole thing would be 0. A minus b, a minus c. A minus B and A minus C. So this will be cancels. So that will turn out like 0 plus 1 and A minus A 0. So 0 is equal to 1, which will satisfy the equation, isn't it? Now if I put X is equal to B, then B minus A, B minus B would turn out 0. B minus B would be 0 and 0 into everything is 0. B minus B is 0, that will be 0. But here B minus C and B minus A, B minus C, B minus A. Numerator and denominator would be same. In that case, they will cancel out. And what is left? 1. So in that case, it would be 0 plus 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. That is also satisfied. Now, if I would put X is equal to C, then what will happen? C minus A, C minus B. C minus A, C minus B. That is 1. And C minus C, 0. So whole thing will be 0. C minus C, 0. Whole thing 0. And therefore 0 plus 0 is equal to 1. So they are also satisfying, you know. These are also satisfying. So here there are three values of X, A, B, C satisfy the equation. But the equation was quadratic. And I have told, yes, I agree that any equation of degree n cannot have more than n roots. Here, this is a quadratic equation which cannot have more than two roots. And here I have shown myself that there are three values of x which will satisfy the equation. What is that? Will you tell me? Do you have any idea? You may ask your teachers in class. You will find the solution. If he or she will be able to tell you, what is that? Reply. But I will not let you to ask to the teachers and wait till then I will reply. What is that? This is called an identity. If any equation, note down, term is identity. Identity. If any equation of degree n, any equation of degree n has more than n value, more than n value which will satisfy the equation, which will satisfy the equation, then it is called identity. It is called identity. Identity. In SA1, you have studied about sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Do you? Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. How many value of sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 where theta can satisfy? Infinite. Sine square 10 degree plus cos square 10 degree also 1. Sine square 5 degree plus cos square 5 degree also 1. Sine square 50 plus cos square 50 also 1. So there are infinite value of theta which will satisfy that particular equation. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, it is called trigonometric identity. The chapter itself written trigonometric identity. Why? Because it has infinite number of value which will satisfy the equation. So similar like here in quadratic equation, if any equation of degree n which has more than n value which will satisfy the equation, then it is called a quadratic equation. It is an identity, not a roots. These are here a, b, c are three values which will satisfy the equation. They are identity, they are not considered as roots of the equation. Got the point? So there are a difference between roots and identity. Roots are those which will satisfy the equation, but it will be always less than or equal to the degree of the equation. A cubic equation can have maximum three value of x, three roots which will satisfy the equation. A biquadratic cannot have more than four value which will satisfy the equation. Maximum can be four, minimum can be zero. Got the point? So any equation of degree n cannot have more than n roots. If there are more than n value which will satisfy the equation, then it is called an identity. I hope you all understand it. Clear? Okay. So let me discuss about the quadratic, roots of quadratic equation and how we can find the roots of the equation. So quadratic equation is what? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. I want to develop the basic concept, and that is why lectures are quite elaborative. It will develop your depth of knowledge and conceptual approach about the question as well. So that is why don't worry about the length of the video, because I am going to tell you each and every aspect of this topic, so that clarity of each and every point must be in your mind, and therefore try to understand this. Ax square plus bx plus c, we have to find the value of x. So what to do? How can you find the value of x? Because a is not equal to 0, it is given in the condition. So I can divide thoroughly this equation by a. So when you divide by a, what will happen? B by a into x plus c by a is equal to 0. What I did here? I have divided by a throughout the equation. Now to make perfect square, what to do? You have studied in class 10th, essay 1, what to do for making a perfect square? Add and subtract square of half of coefficient of x. If you have no idea, then please note down. These are few steps that you can consider. Step 1, how to make perfect square. Try to learn it. How to make perfect square. Perfect square. Perfect square. What to do? First thing, step 1. Make the coefficient of x square unity. The coefficient of x square unity. Right? Then step 2. Add and subtract. Subtract a square of half of coefficient of x. Add and subtract square of half of coefficient of x, then it will turn that perfect square. So what I did here, I have made first step here, that coefficient of x square is unity, and for this what I did, I had divided throughout the equation by a. Now add and subtract step 2, half of the coefficient of x, a square of the half of the coefficient of x. What is the coefficient of x? B by a. What would be half of this? B by 2a. B by a, half of this, half of everything, B by a is there, and half of that is, half of this is B by 2a. So I have to add and subtract b by 2a whole square. So what will happen? X square plus b by a x plus b by 2a whole square, and since I have added, so I need to subtract also. plus C by A is equal to 0. That will come. Now, this further can be rearranged. Bx square plus 2 into B by 2 into x into B by 2a plus B by 2a whole square is equal to B by 2a whole square minus C by A. Can I write like this? 2 I have divided by 2 here, so multiply by 2 here. This was negative term, so in other side it would be positive. And this was positive, so in other side it would be negative. Clear na? I hope you got it. Yes? Okay. So, this is A square. If you consider this like A square plus 2AB plus B square. What is the formula? Will you tell me? A square plus 2AB plus B square? Yes, you can say A plus B whole square. And instead of A, there is X. In place of B, there is B by 2A. So it would be B square by 4A square minus C by A. B square and 2A whole square would be 4A square minus C by A. So X plus B by 2A. If I remove the square from this side, A whole square is equal to B square minus 4AC upon 4A square. LCM of 4A square and A would be 4A square. Right now? You know now how to find LCM? Yes. You know that? So 4A square and A would be 4A square. And that would be 4A square divided by 4A square is 1. 1 multiplied by B square is B square. 4A square divided by A would be 4A and 4A multiplied by C is 4AC. Now if I remove the square from this side, then other side it would be plus minus root of that 4AC and 4A square would be also inside the root, but when it will come outside it will be 2A. It means X is equal to minus B by 2A plus minus B square minus 4AC whole divided by 2a. That can be written as further minus b plus minus root d divided by 2a. LCM of 2a and 2a is 2a. This is minus b plus minus. That I have written d. Why this d and what is the meaning of this d? Here b square minus 4ac tell you many things. As we have discussed in the previous question, that square root of negative terms will not give real value. Remember, I told you x square is equal to minus 4, then x is equal to under root of minus 4. So, in that case, under root of minus 4 will not give any real value. It means if under root of this thing would be negative, then there is no real roots. It means this is the things which will decide whether roots are real or not. And that is called discriminant. D for discriminant, which will discriminate further that whether roots are real or not real. So that is why this term is denoted as D, and D means discriminant. So what is that? Let me explain what we have. D is discriminant. Another term comes here in mind, discriminant. Discriminant, what is that? D. And D is B square minus 4AC. Discriminant is D and D is equal to B square minus 4AC. So in that case, what would happen? That D, if it will be positive, then minus B plus minus some positive will give two distinct values. Suppose here B is 2 and D is 16. Then the square root of 16 would be 4. So minus 2 plus minus 4. Minus 2 plus 4. Minus 2 minus 4. Will it give two different value? Yes. So two different real value will be given if D is a positive number. So if D is a positive number, then there will be two different real roots. And if it is positive, then roots are real. Otherwise, if it is negative, then a square root of negative number do not exist. In that case, we can say roots are not real. Got the point? So, conditions, these are the cases. Following cases can be considered case first. When D is greater than 0, greater than or equal to even 0, roots are real. Roots are real. Right? Case 2, when D is greater than 0, then roots are means value of x are real and unequal. Roots are real and unequal. Real and unequal. When D is equal to 0, what will happen? Will you tell me? If D is equal to 0, something, so minus B plus 0 and minus B minus 0, will it give two distinct value? No, no. Minus B plus 0 and minus B minus 0 will give the same value. So value of x will be same, equal. So in that case, roots are real and equal. Real and equal. And when D is less than 0, then you have seen this, roots are imaginary. So we have seen that there are four cases, you know. So roots are real, roots are imaginary, when roots will be equal. All this can be observed and analyzed by finding the value of D. And what is the value of D, my dear friend? Value of D is b square minus 4ac. So will you remember this? Yes. Will you remember this? Value of D is b square minus 4ac. And why the name is given? Because it will discriminate about the nature of the roots. It will tell about the nature of the roots, that what kind of possible roots of equation will come, whether it will be real or it will be imaginary. If it is real, then whether they are equal or not equal. So all these characteristics described by D, and that is why D is called discriminant, and these are the characteristics. So these are characteristics of root. Characteristics of roots can be determined by this. So I hope you have understand what is the roots. Now in next lecture we will discuss about the different questions, how to attempt the question, how to solve the question, what are the criteria in which we can deal with the questions. But till then, I am giving you two homework. Please remember, read all this once again, twice or thrice. Unless it gives a clear picture in mind, don't let it to study again and again and watch this video again and again. Now, thereafter you have to learn two things. One thing, what is the difference between roots and identity? If any equation has more than n value which will satisfy the equation, then it is called an identity. Remember na? Understood na? Okay. Next thing, what you will remember? That value of x is this one, minus b plus minus root under d by 2a. And what is b? D is b square minus 4ac. And thereafter, you will recognize this and remember this characteristics. Four characteristics I have described. Although, if you go in 11th, some more characteristics are there. But I don't want to make you puzzle in putting all those things together right now. So, it is enough information and it is more than sufficient for you. So, you remember this, that if there are four cases, four situations in which we can analyze what will be the nature of the roots and how we can analyze this by finding the value of D, that is b square minus 4ac. So I think this is a good one. You will remember all those things and watch the next video. Thank you very much.